previous episode, we saw how can we identify what kind of colors we have inside the bearings of the conrods and the crankshaft itself if we don't have any markings on the crankcases or the crankshaft. On this episode, let's see what other measurements we need to do on this engine in order to make sure that it's going to be in working condition.
This is how we measure the valve stem runout. And the maximum runout is 0.05 millimeters. More than that, replace the valve. And then one measurement of the valve head radial runout, which should be no more than 0.03 millimeters. And then measure the valve head thickness, which is that. Make sure it's no less than 0.5 millimeter. Less than 0.5 millimeter, you have to replace the valve.
Another thing that you should pay attention to is the top of the stem of the valve. If it's damaged or anything, you can always shave it and on a lathe, take it to machinist's shop and do the job. But remember, Suzuki states that the tip, which is that little part, must not be less than 2.5 millimeters. If it's less than 2.5, you have to replace the valve. Valve spring free length, that's one thing you have to check as well. Let's go with the inner first. Inlet and exhaust valves are all the same. They're defined 0.05. The service limit for these ones, for the inner, is 33.9 millimeters. So we're really well with that. Now let's go for the outer one and let's see what we got. 38.7, and the free string length for these ones, the outer ones, is 37.3, so good with that one as well.
Let's measure for cylinder head distortion. If you have a level, just put it on top of the cylinder head and then try to put the 0.20 millimeters filler gauge. It should not go through at any point of the cylinder head where the level is on it. Make sure the surface is absolutely clean, otherwise you will have false indications. And you have to measure in 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then vertical 5 and 6. No more than 0.20 millimeters. If it's more than that, you have to take it to machinist and just shave it a bit. Another measurement for the valve is to do the valve guide valve stem clearance. Put the valve as far as it can go until it stops on the seal. Then approach the micrometer and try to do sideways movements. Must not be more than 0.35 millimeters. And you have to measure in all both directions. North, south, east, west. And if the average is more than 0.35 millimeters, you start to considering replacing either the guides or the valve. To check the valve stem if it's correct, the right diameter, you have to measure it at this spot right here where it seems to be polished, because this is the operational area. Don't measure down here, it doesn't do anything, or up here. Measure it where you see it's polished, because this is where it slides into the guide. Take a micrometer and measure the stem. Now, for inlet valves, the standard stem, it should be 4.965 to 4.980 millimeters, while the exhaust valves, it's 4.945 to 4.960 millimeters. Anything less than that, the valves need to be replaced. And the last thing to check on the valves is the seat, how wide it is, that polished area right there. That should be 0.9 to 1.1 millimeters.
Take one of these, and then you can measure with the help of the micrometer what's the internal diameter. And you measure what you have. Now, Suzuki states that for each one of the inlet and exhaust camshaft joints, the standard dimension is 22.012 to 22.025 millimeters. I'm guessing out of specs, that means we have to replace the cylinder head, unfortunately. Next thing you need to measure is the joint on the camshaft itself. that way you have the internal diameter on this, the external diameter of this, so you abstract that from that and you have your gap. And if the gap is 0.150, that's fine, up to that. If it's more than that, then we have some serious issues and we need to see which one of these two parts to replace. Either really expensive. The next check is the camshaft runout. You support it on the edges and then you check on the middle journal. Some dirt there, but still good. The maximum runout limit wear is 1/10 of a millimeter for both inlet and exhaust camshafts, so we're still good.
And there's no way to restore an engine without checking the cam chain.
Suzuki states for these models you have to check the 20 pitch thing. You have to stretch the chain, keep it stretched. That's when a friend is going to be useful. And then measure 20 pitches across. Now, I'm a bit confused because in the manual says 20 pitches. As you can see, I marked them over here with a bit of white marker. That's the first, and this is the 21st. It says 20 pitches, but as you can see up on your screen, this is a copy from the Suzuki Service Manual, the original. It states on the 21st pitch you measure, from center to center. And of course, couldn't be any worse. My bearing calipers is less than 158 millimeters, which is the service limit for the cam chain. And it shows there 154.6, but that little gap over here, I don't think that's another 3.5 millimeters. It's less than that. So this chain seems to be still in working condition and it's still great. If it's more than that, that means that the chain is stretched way too far and it's not really a good idea to put it back on the engine. You better replace it. Of course, we need to check the piston size. Piston size need to be checked at about 15 millimeters from the bottom of the skid, which is about somewhere there. And Suzuki states it should be the service limit 72.880 millimeters. If it's less than that, we have a worn piston. That means we have to replace the piston, unfortunately. This is a standard size piston. Oversize, they do not state how much is the service limit for them. I only know about the standard. Now we have to measure the piston ring and groove clearance between the first and the second piston rings. It should be 0.18 and no more than that. That stops. And we put it right into the groove if it fits. It doesn't fit in there. So I guess we're good on the first and it doesn't fit on the second. If it does fit and it fits in up to 0.18 millimeters, that's fine. But after that, you need to see which of the two is worn. Is it the piston rings or the piston grooves in there and you have to replace the piston? How we can determine that? Let's see. With the use of a micrometer, we measure the thickness of the piston rings. And both compression rings, first and second, have a standard size of 0.77 to 0.79 millimeters. If it's less than that, you have to replace them. The other thing you need to measure in here, and I'm not sure if you can do that with the vernier caliper, I would go with a filler gauge thick enough to fill these gaps and the grooves, first and second. The standard size is 0.81 to 0.83 millimeters. So take a filler gauge, 0.81 or 0.83, whatever you have, and fit it in there and see how much the gap is. If it takes thicker blade, go on the thicker blade and determine. Remember, do not squeeze it in there, do not smash it. Just let it go through and align the filler gauge with the grooves of the piston. For the oil, it's 1.51 to 1.53 millimeters. So there you go. That's how you can measure. And these are the specs. For the piston, if you want to go a bit further and you want to measure the piston pin ball on both ends with an internal micrometer, then you should know that the service limit is 19.030 millimeters. And if you want to measure the piston pin, which you'll have to measure it right here, right in the center, the service limit for that is 18.980 millimeters.
And this is something we've done before, and it's very crucial to do. It's the piston ring end gap when the piston ring is inside the cylinder. So turn the cylinders upside down to make it easier. And so we can use a space, an area that it's not worn at all. So we put it in there and just put it around, I don't know, 20 millimeters further down. And I always use the piston to make it go as far as I want and make it go flat. And then I measure that gap over there. That gap over there must not be more than 0.7 millimeters. Put your filler gauge and you try to find out how much it is. If it's less than 0.7 millimeters, we're good to go for both first and second compression piston rings. They don't give us any specs for the oil ring. Now let's check distortion on the cylinder block. Make sure the surface is absolutely clean. You take a blade and you take even the slightest amount of dirt off the surface where the cylinder block meets the cylinder head. And since you have an absolutely clean surface, then and only then you can go and do some checks with a flat blade, steel or whatever. The only thing I have is my lever, which is quite unproportionately large for this job, but anyway. And then you take a filler gauge, 0.2 millimeters. That's the maximum distortion Suzuki allows for the cylinder block, 0.2 millimeters. And you put it under here, 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 anywhere. And then you go that side. You press and you check again, anywhere.
And this is all the checkpoints you have to go through the cylinder block. And if you find more than 0.20 millimeters, you have to replace the cylinder block.
Now let's measure if the cylinder is fit to work with this engine. Well, not just one, all four of them. We have to do six measurements. Like I show you here up on the diagram, which is from the Suzuki manual, you have to check, you have to take two measurements on three different heights. One somewhere at the top, 20 millimeters from the top, I think. One somewhere in the middle of the cylinder, and one, let's say, 20 millimeters from the bottom of the skid. One that way, east-west, and one that way, north-south. Two up here, two in the middle, and two at the very bottom, right there, to have an accurate way of how the cylinders are. So that's one. And then we take it to measure with the micrometer, as I showed you before. And then we take one up here. After we measure it, find out how much it is, put it on a piece of paper. You do that for all these six measurements. A 73.090 millimeters, which is the service limit, then you're good. If it's more than that, I'm guessing that you have to either replace the cylinder with a brand new one or a very good condition used one, or the most expensive way might be to do a boring for an oversize, to do an oversize, but this has to happen to all four of them, and that means you have to replace the pistons and piston rings as well. So that can be more expensive. Maybe the cheapest solution is to find a used one in really good condition or buy a brand new one.
The small end of the conroe, the internal diameter has to be 19.40 millimeters, and then we measure on the micrometer and we found how much it is. Another thing we need to check on all four conroes is the clearance between the conroe and the crankshaft itself. So we put it back together, we torque it in the correct torque specification, and then we push it on one side, and you try to put the filler gauge in here. The service limit is 0.30 millimeters. It doesn't fit. It doesn't fit. Actually, I checked each one of them. It doesn't fit. It's way far from the service limit. But if you have above 0.30, then you are in serious trouble. You need to replace either conroes or crankshaft or both. Which one? Let's see. You remove the conroe that appears to have a problem out, and you take the micrometer and you measure it right on this spot. Right here. Now Suzuki states the standard in here should be 20.95 to 21 millimeters. If it's less than that, we have a problem. The next thing
the crankshaft. For the crankshaft, we have to measure from this surface to that surface over there. And we can do that with an internal micrometer, which I don't have. And the standard of that crank pin width should be 21.10 to 21.15. If it's more than that, then we have a lot of gap here and the whole crankshaft, you have to replace it. Roughly, this is an idea of how you do the crankshaft run out. You put it on the V-blocks, but that's not the correct way to do it. No plastic should be involved. You need to have a machinist steel plate, which is absolutely flat. Put the V-blocks up there, put your dial gauge here on the center, and you have to check the run out as you turn the crankshaft and see how much the run out is. The service limit is 0.05 millimeters. More than that, you need to replace the crankshaft for sure. I just did this to show you how it's done. I don't have the equipment. I have to take it to a specialist to do that measurement. The drive plates, as they call them, they do have a maximum or minimum thickness. What you need to do is something that I can't at the moment. I'll have to take it with my crankshaft to a specialist. Put each one of them on a machinist plate surface flat, and put the filler gauge underneath. The maximum distortion, if there's any distortion, should be 0.10 millimeters, no more than a tenth of the millimeter. Usually for pretty much every motorcycle, that's the service limit, 0.10 millimeters distortion. You have to check each one of them. And guys, I think I covered everything for that engine. If I missed something, just let me know and I'll see what I can do to cover it on our next episode. That's all the measurements you need when you have to check the engine of your GSX-R750 88 to 89 models. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video, which will come within the couple next months as I'm going really slow. Alright guys, I'll see you in the next video. Take care.